After Effects isn't exactly an audio powerhouse, but hey, that doesn't mean that you can't make sweet music or sound with it. In fact, I'd argue that you should add audio to everything you create. Maybe you've got a banging audio track and you want to match your graphics to it? Well, in this short video, I'll show you everything you need to know about wrangling audio in After Effects. Quick fun fact. In my early 20s, I was a DJ, and yes, I still have a pretty impressive vinyl collection, tons of 80s maxi singles that I jam to on a daily basis. Want to see some of the incredible album artwork? Well, follow me on Instagram, where I show off my favorite covers. But hey, this is YouTube, and as you probably know by now, we talk mostly about visuals in this channel, specifically After Effects. So today, I'm dropping some needle on the record tips to help you work with audio in the software, and maybe, just maybe, I'll show you something you didn't already know. All right? Let's drop the beat and dive in. To see those funky audio waveforms, select a clip with audio or even a few and hit the letter L twice, so LL in sequence, and bam, waveform magic. If you tap the letter L once, you only see the audio levels. But if you're feeling fancy and you already have the waveform showing, add shift to the mix, so shift plus L, and you can see them both. Now you can scrub those levels like a pro, or use the audio meter's knob, the middle one, to adjust your audio in real time. But this will work just for a single clip. Hold down Command on Mac, Control on Windows, and drag the CTI to hear a digital scrub. This is perfect for making sure sound matches your visual action. You can also place the time ruler above an audio cue, then hold down Command or Control and click to hear a sweet little 5-frame loop going forward. Wow, quite handy. Do you hate the terrifying sound After Effects makes when it caches audio and video together? Me too. So let's go to the settings on the Mac, which are the preferences on Windows, and then head directly to the preview settings and check mute audio when preview is not real time. This is going to save your ears. If you have an extended keyboard, while you fancy, press the period key on the numpad to listen to your timeline's audio in real time without any video distraction. Want to fade your audio in or out? Don't mess with the audio levels property unless you love abrupt changes, because this is working with decibels. Instead, slap on the stereo mixer effect and then keyframe the left and right levels. You can do it from 0 to 100 or the other way around, depending on what you want to do, fade in or fade out. And this is going to get you a smoother, more natural sound, almost like butter or a police tune that never ends. Now we all know After Effects isn't the best at handling complex audio mixes. That's where Adobe Audition comes in. You can send a single audio file from After Effects to Audition via the Edit menu. This is great if you just want to edit a specific track. Or better yet, you can bring your whole After Effects comp into Audition as a dynamic link file. To do this, go to the import file and then select your .aep file, which is the After Effects project. And then in this pop-up menu, pick the comp that you like and then drag the file into the video reference track to finish the mix. Once you're happy with it, we can export the multi-track mix and bring the file back into After Effects as I did with this example. Easy peasy. And this is it for this time. A few quick tips to help you match audio to your motion graphics and be as cool as Nile Rodgers or whoever you adore. If you want to see how After Effects plays nicely with other Adobe apps, click here or check the full playlist below. Thank you so much for watching, liking, subscribing, and creating.